of loving you. I just can't believe. I just can't believe the world of this feeling to me. I just can't believe it's true. I should have got it.
Oh, honey, honey, you are my candy girl boy, and you got me missing you. Oh, honey, oh, sugar, sugar, you are my candy girl boy, and you got me wanting you and missing you, missing you. Welcome, love bugs. Welcome to art. Guess what we're doing today? You'll never guess. Hey, welcome. Hey, another week in art in my kitchen. What do you think? Getting used to it? I hope so. So what do you think of all of this? Do you think that I have this at my house every single day? Are you kidding me? I bought it just for you. If you were here, I'd share it with you, but I guess I'm gonna have to eat it, or I have a feeling Roman and Rocco will eat it very quickly when I'm done with this video. So, you're asking yourself, why does Jennifer have all this? Well, it's because of art. There was an artist by the name of Wayne Thiebold, and he painted pies and cakes and donuts and gumball machines and ice cream cones and all these sweet things. And at first people thought, is he a little bit crazy? I don't know how he painted all these things and didn't eat them all at once. He has a pretty interesting story. He was born in Arizona, and he's actually still alive. He's 100 years old, believe it or not. But he had many different jobs. He was a sign painter and an illustrator, and he made posters for movies, and he even worked as an illustrator for Walt Disney World. But he realized that he could actually make money from his paintings. But at first, he really didn't have a distinct style. And a friend of his, who was also a famous painter by the name of William de Kooning, said to him, Wayne, stop copying everybody else and find your own style. Find something that you like to paint, something that makes you happy. And so Wayne took some time off and he began teaching in the college in New York City, and then he went back to his painting. And he said that he sat in his studio and he was just sketching with pencil shapes, ovals and circles, and all of a sudden these ovals and circles started to turn into pies and cakes. He had once worked at a restaurant, and when you worked at diners in the old days, they would have these big glass display cases where they would show the pie. Sometimes at Bob Evans, they show them like that. And he remembered how the pies would be lined up in the display cases, or to be served in the back where the waitresses would pick them up. And so he began painting from memory, the pies and the cakes and the slices of cakes and the slices of pies and the ice cream cones. And he began painting these on canvas. He kind of thought to himself, am I nuts? Should I be doing this? Are people aren't gonna think this is art? But he couldn't step away from it. And so he continued painting these beautiful works with different sweets. And sometimes he would paint things that came from maybe a woman's makeup drawer, lipsticks, or her closet, high heels. And he began to sell his work, and he began to make money, and he began to be recognized as a great American artist. And you can tell his work because of, first of all, of the subject matter, the still lives. And you remember what a still life is? It's a collection of objects set on a table. It could be flowers, could be pies and cakes, could be shoes, could be anything. So he continued to make these still lives. And what was interesting in these still lives with all the pies, sometimes they look like these tables of desserts that would go on and on forever. Like you just thought, do they ever end? The one thing that he always shows in many of his works are these shadows. The shadows next to the pies or the cakes. And the colors that he uses are, sometimes I call them like the sherbet colors. Some are pastels, some are bright. Some you can see the warm and the cool colors next to each other, which make the subject matter pop. We've talked about putting warm and cool colors together in class. Sometimes he uses different shades of one color. But you'll always be able to pick out a Wayne Thiebold painting by the subject matter. You'll see the cakes and the pies. What I want you to do next is you are going to look at several works of his, and I want you to begin to look at them, stop the video, and look at them and study them. And I want you first to figure out what jumps out in the painting. What do you see first? What colors does he use? Does he place warm and cool colors next to each other? And what is the background? Because his backgrounds, and I don't want to tell you about his backgrounds because I want you to figure it out. What do his backgrounds all have in common? Is there a lot of detail? You're going to answer that question. Do you see his brush strokes in his paintings? Is there repetition? Do you see things repeated? Sometimes you may not. Most of all, do you see the shadows? What color do you see in the shadows? What colors jumps out to you in a Wayne Thiebold shadow? And finally, what do all of his works have in common? And after you look at these and discuss them, and oh, by the way, look at them with somebody in your family or whoever is in the house. I'm not going to say friends because we shouldn't have friends in our house right now. But it's fun to discuss a painting with someone else because they might bring up things that you're not considering or seeing. And it really sort of makes for a really interesting conversation when you look at artwork with someone else. Okay, so I'll see you after you look at your Wayne Thiebold works of art, okay? Oh my gosh, am I gonna eat all this? Oh my gosh, I just wanna put my face in that cake. Ah! All right, have fun. I'll see you in a few. Mwah. see. So what'd you think of his work? My gosh, did it make you hungry? Anytime you look at his work, it makes you hungry. In fact, when you're done with the art project, maybe you can bake a cake or cupcakes or pie. Oh my gosh, if you know how to make a pie, I will be totally impressed. Did I tell you how hard this quarantine is for me? Because Jennifer is not a cook. I've had to cook every meal. It's been very difficult for me. Okay, so what I want you to do now is I want you to look this site up, okay? It is Wayne Thiebaud, and it is a video on YouTube, CBS Sunday Morning, which is one of my favorite shows ever. I want you to watch this, okay? I'm not so techie that I know how to put the video connected to my YouTube. So bear with me, okay? So stop the video, look this up, and I'll meet you back in a second. I think I'm gonna go eat a cupcake. Alrighty, so
what do you think we're doing?
This is cool, isn't it? We are gonna be creating a Wayne Thiebaud, very simplistic cake with the slice cut out on the cake stand. And I want you to notice how everything is very simple. The background is simple. The cake is simple. But if you want to add some designs to your cake, oh, good Lord, go ahead and do it, sister or brother. So I want to show you there's actually different steps to create the cake. And we are going to follow these steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then over here, it shows you how you could do a layer cake if you want to. So you could always come back and stop the video and follow these steps if you don't want to follow along with me. It's really cool when you do this the first time. So what you're going to need is your pencil and piece of paper and some markers, okay? Or crayons, it's up to you. So let's do step one. Step one is we're actually going to be creating the oval of the cake. And so what I like to do is start towards the top, and to do an oval, you know how you do a really nice oval? Keep your hand right in the middle of the paper and watch how I just move my pencil back and forth, keeping my hand anchored. And notice how by keeping it anchored, you get this really nice curve. Now, flip it over. Okay, and figure out how wide you want it to be. I'm gonna do mine about this wide. Hold your hand like right in the middle and do the same curved line, but don't go all the way over, okay? And you will have this really nice oval shape, and then you can come back and attach the ends with a nice curved shape. There you go. And then you'll have a perfect cake top. Okay, just like that. Okay, so we've done our number one. Now what we're gonna do is number two, and we're actually going to bring down some vertical lines. Figure out how tall you want your cake, okay? And then again, I'm gonna pull it over and I'm gonna do the same thing, put my hand in the middle, and I'm going to make that line, curved line. Okay, I'm gonna bring that back down. Okay, so now we have step two completed. And remember, this should be up higher on the paper. Step three, I'm gonna put a dot right in the center of that oval. Put a dot, because that's going to guide us to do the rest. Okay, step four, I am going to do the top part of my slice. I'm going to do an upside down V, okay? There we go, just a V right down to the edge of the oval. That's it, okay? So now we've done step four. Step five is I'm going to take two lines, the bottom of my V, and draw vertical lines that are parallel to each other. Okay, there's step four or five, sorry. And now step six, I'm going to erase the top of that oval. So get that line out. Okay. And then for step seven, I want to erase the bottom of that line too. I'm sorry. You want to get both lines out. Okay. So now you've got this big hole in the cake. So now that's where you are, step six. So step seven, you're going to start at the bottom right here. And do you see this upside down V? You're going to make that same V. Make sure that you have the top of that V in the middle, which is directly underneath that circle. Okay. So now can you see where the cake is being cut out? You've got that shape. So there's seven. Step eight, you're going to draw a line going straight down. And then step nine, I'm going to show some frosting layers, which are diagonal lines. Don't go straight across. Make sure they're diagonal with and even with the diagonal line at the top and the bottom. So look at that line. Make it the same angle. Here's that angle. Drop down. Same angle. Okay. So there we have our frosting. Doesn't that look good? So now we're at step nine. Now the cake pan, that's very easy. All you do is put your hand in the middle and do exactly what I did before. Kind of get that curved line over. I'm going to flip my hand upside down again, and I'm going to do that curved line and round it out. So we have our perfect cake plate. And I'm going to give it a little bit of a rim. I'm just going to come down slightly and bring it over. So we have just a little bit of an edge of our cake pan. Now what we're going to do is, you can see how I have the bottom of the cake pan. What do you call it? Not cake pan, but the cake platter. So I'm going to curve in. I'm going to curve in, and then again, one of those round bottoms, okay? See, that's why I think it's always better if you go like this with your hand in one motion and flip it over. That way you get a really nice, even oval. See how that works? I love doing that. It makes me happy when I do that. Okay, so you erase that. And now you have your beautiful Wayne Thiebold cake. Hey, you know what you need to do after this project? You need to make a cake or cupcakes, something. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your markers and you are going to color your cake. Now, you can see that I've used different colors. It's very simple. You actually can see my marker lines. And, I used cool colors against warm colors because I wanted it to pop. So have fun with this. I really think that these will be, really cool. And there's something about drawing this where you get this piece of cake out that you're like, oh my gosh, I did that. Whoa, that's pretty cool. And then the next thing you know, you're drawing a ton of them. And if you want to do layer cakes, what you do is you start with a big cake at the bottom and then you put, just draw the whole cake, then put another cake on top of it, draw the whole cake, a smaller one, and then even a smaller one. And then what you do is you go erase the lines that are behind it, and then you'll have a full cake. So if you want to try just a single cake like this, or if you want to try layer cake, go ahead. It's up to you, baby cakes. Have fun. Hey, I miss you guys so much. I can't wait to see all of you. This really stinks, but we'll get through it. We'll be back in my art room, listen to tunes. Always remember to put some music on when you're doing art. Please promise me that. All right? Okay. I miss you. See you later, alligators.
Mom, can we eat it?
Don't you, look at this. Don't nice you dare. Get your hands off of it. Get your hands off of it right now. Oh, I need it for my art class. Don't you dare. Donuts. Don't you dare, you chow hounds. Don't you dare. Roman, put that down right now.